What is up, everybody? Welcome back, and we are in a ship, Cat Eye, on the desert moving ground map. So it's gonna be like the half first episode of a new series where we test mod trucks and tell you if they're overpowered or if they're pretty realistic gameplay. So do is tink. We're gonna do turbo this one first. We're gonna go customize this thing and see what attachments we can get. So already balanced, high performance, upgraded, logging. This gives us nothing. Power to weight is really good. It's already a gas guzzler. Okay. I think we're gonna go with the high performance. Highway logging off-road gearbox. That's gonna give us less speed, but we don't need this to be very speedy. You do have a lot of suspension. We're gonna go with the Flexi Boy suspension and see what that does for us. Tires. Mud and tires, don't really need those. 44 is like pretty small right now. 47, there we go. No boggers. Assassinators, we'll go with the Maxis Rockzilla because we're on the proving grounds. We don't need it. Okay, there's no winch, which there's no customizable winch. We'll go with custom bumper one. No bed cap. Maybe we can go with these bushwhacker fenders. No back rack. No toolbox. And no bumper weight. Alright. Well, let's see. I'm assuming that the exhaust is gonna be... Yep. We'll go with the diamond stack rear bumper. It doesn't automatically switch you to the view that you want for your customization. We're gonna go with the dually fenders, even though that gets rid of our nice. We're gonna leave it stock paint job. Okay. So while we're headed to our trail, let's see what kind of speed this thing can get. You can only manually shift up if you're headed. It's not super fast, which is good. I don't know why you would want a fast track this game. Jeez. You need to download a speedometer. Take it slow. So I did a little off-screen gameplay and I came up with a gladiator before. I didn't go too far. I'll say when I get to the part that I got to. Please, okay, struggling on the tight corners, or on the tightness. Our goal is to see if this truck can make it through everything without going to the low. We're in low, it should be better. Okay, probably should go with singles. I don't think I'm gonna do any crawling in this truck. Let's take a moment and appreciate the suspension. Power automatic. Feels like the automatic has more power in this truck. A little higher, a little low. This is the part where I stopped with the beep. So we can just go ahead and go on down here. Now this part's new to me. A big map. Definitely should have gotten the shoes. A little wide. Hit more. Barely made it up some of the crevices back there. So if I didn't do any crawling with this truck. Which, not to say that it doesn't do good with the wheels, but maybe figure out different configurations. Like, I did the single configuration, I won't be doing pretty much any other configs with this truck. We might revisit it. It is really nice, and there's been no glitches with it so far besides the weird garage can. I like the diamond stacks and the color. 47s are starting to look big now. Looks like they were small earlier. They are not. Put it back in automatic. We already shifted in the low, so we didn't make the accomplishment. I literally said that we should try to accomplish this without shifting in the low, and I shifted in the low like 5 seconds ago. welcome to Death Bridge, everyone. I've named it now. I never even noticed there's fucking food down there earlier. I'm glad you were. Then I'll scale a 1 to 10. How sketchy is this turn? How sketchy is the one up there? Only 3.7? Oh, hold on, oh no, god. Yeah. We're going in low upper. I've called low high and low and ultra low so many things. I've called it super low, ultra low, low minus. Low. Hold it low plus. High low. Low upper. Oh jeez. I'm not comfortable with this scenario right now. Okay, yeah, I forgot you gotta not an automatic, you gotta shift to reverse. I would rather not, Charlie. I forgot that your axles can't collide. Alright. Well, we made it out. So, let's go ahead and test another truck. So I had a couple trucks in mind. Mods only. We're only doing two trucks today, by the way, so. You know, I'm gonna, no, we'll save the burb side for next video. Alright, why not? We're going with the Colorado. That is a mean looking Colorado. Doesn't have a V8? That's lame. Alright, we're going with the twin Turbski. 4-speed off-road. Suspension height. Why do they lift in the back like that? That's so ugly. Okay, we're gonna go with extreme lift because that's what saved us on the last try. Jeez, tires. Dang. So 35s is the biggest you can get on this. We'll go with the all terrain. This is one ugly truck. We don't need a winch because there's no winch points on this map. Yikes. Yeah, yikes. Go with the steel basher. Our roll bars are all really ugly. I'll go with those spare tires, jerry cans. snorkel even though this map is dry. Chevy logo, obviously. Which light bar is better? I like the old one. Beadlocks. I'm kind of digging black on this truck. Either black or... yeah, we're gonna go with black. Whoa. In good tradition here, we're gonna rev the engine before we take off. Doesn't have a very good engine sound. That was a good idle sound, but that's about it. Here's the departure season. Leave it off a cliff. We overshot that. How do we already get our tires ready? We've been on pavement this whole time. This way. Whoa. That was a real rev there. Oh, it literally just took us a long way around. Maybe it was a shortcut. A shortcut isn't actually a shortcut, it's just the right way to get there. Why would you need gas already? I guess if you had a Dodge. You know, who would want one of those? Literally nobody, unless you're weird. I mean, well, that looks like something that we gotta drive on. Oh, jeez. Dad, we're gonna have to come here and build trucks and race them on this off-road racetrack. Look at this. Yeah, this Colorado really ain't cutting it. Tell Gramps I'm sorry, but I don't approve of his choice. At least in its off-road capabilities. Oh, jeez. Shift to second gear, that's good. This is third gear of it. The thing with SnowRunner is you don't slow down. Because if you do, it's going to take you 7 years to get that next. This is actually really nice, like, oh geez, not really nice. Don't approve. 1 out of 10, good not. See that dirt fly? I landed like face first. Don't get me wrong, I do love me a Chevy, but this is just not for me. Almost back. Yah, yeet. Uh-oh. A Hey Dad, remember the suspension pack that I installed earlier? Well, not anymore. Well, now we got a lowrider. Okay, I genuinely thought that we were supposed to jump that. I guess we're gonna keep going. Maybe. Well, we'll find out in the next episode. Oh jeez, oh god, oh jeez. So the suspension works when you jump up into the air, like straightens out again. I've watched this one. Wait, what was this? There's gotta be suspension. Okay, Dad, here we go. Why do you do this to me? You know, nothing broke because everything's already broken.
You're losing gas and leaking gas all over.
I can literally hear it pumping. And so can the people watching this video. See, look, the suspension works again. Gee, look at this. Alright, well. That's going to be it for today's episode, everybody. I will see you in the next one.